Like at the end of this session, we will have some tasks for you so that you can do some front end stuff. So we will have some tasks for you at the end of this session.
This site is very good and very interesting. You can improve your CSS skills, and you won't even feel like you're actually doing something, because it's so much fun and code such things. Like you'll be coding random images, random logos, and just with the help of CSS.
You know about incandescence, you know about incand oh sorry, technosis. You know about technosis. Do you guys know about technosis? First year guys, do you know about technosis?
Not much.
If you don't know, this is the annual
Technoise is basically the annual technical fest of our college.
technical festival of our college, and there's many technical events in that fest, right? So some of them are based on web development also. So one of the event is purely based on your CSS and JavaScript skills, purely based on those two skills. So it's good to know CSS or JavaScript.
On the last day of our sessions, we'll show you the website of Technoise. It was actually very nice.
No,
And
you like that with Technosis website last year. Technosis website was like, even compare that website like what I should say, like you can compare that website to many IITs or any like many much better engineering colleges. Like the website was too good, I must say.
And we do not hire anyone to develop our website. It's done by the students ourselves.
From our college institute, from our institute only, the developers were from our institute. Our seniors developed the website. It was really good. Basically,
Even you guys can also be part of the team.
most of the times, only students develop the website whether it is for Technosys, whether it is for Incand or any other event that is going to be organized in our institute. Most of the times, it's just the students that develop the website.
Shall we start, Bia?
Yeah, this
Yeah.
year we can. I guess we can start because it's getting late otherwise.
Yeah.
Okay.
We,
Okay. Yeah,
okay.
you can start.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good evening, everyone. I'm Stefania, and I'm the web module of DSC. So today we'll be doing Flexbox, and we'll be adding some animation and also JavaScript introduction. So let me just share my screen. Is my screen visible?
Yes, Nishi, it's visible.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Yes, thank you.
So these are the two pages which we have created using Flexbox. Some animations and the other pages. So let me show you the magic of Flexbox. See, using Flexbox, these cards will just arrange themselves without even writing anything. It will be presentable at any width.
Okay,
we just need to
for your knowledge, the code that we have written in the first two sessions were just for the desktop view. Okay, those codes, if you host your website and you run the, if you, open that hosted URL in your phone, then the website won't look the same as it looks on your desktop. Okay, and there will be some of the things being misaligned and some of the things not placed properly. So to make the your page or your website responsive or to or mobile friendly, it's known as mobile responsiveness of the website. So kind of this tags like CSS elements like Flexbox and Grid makes it very easier to make it mobile responsive as compared to directly manually writing code and making it mobile responsive. Like we'll have to adjust the responsiveness based on various other mobile width and height. So using Flexbox, it becomes very easy. This is the general idea of why we use Flexbox and grids when we can directly move on to code.
Yeah. So this will be the desktop view, and like this will be the website if we open it in a tab. And for the mobile view, okay, let me just start with the what is Flexbox in the explanation part. Okay, see in a Flexbox, there are two main accesses. One is called as the main axis and the other is called the cross axis. Main axis is always in the direction in what the Flexbox is. Like see, it is arranged in a row. All the boxes are arranged in a row. So the main axis will be horizontal and the cross axis is always perpendicular to the main axis. So it will be vertical. And why are they important, the main axis and cross axis? They're important because if you want to align all the boxes along the along the main axis, then we need to use justify content. And if you want to align them along the vertical axis, then we have to use align items. Let me show some examples. Yeah. So here I've created three boxes, like Flexbox 1, 2, and 3, and they're all wrapped in a Flexbox container. Okay, and then see, so now all the Flexboxes are arranged in a column, no? So once we give the display flex, once we give it display flex to the Flexbox container, then all the boxes will arrange themselves row wise. Let it just reload. Yeah, so you can see now all the boxes have just arranged themselves in row wise. So this is the default arrangement of Flexbox. Whenever you give the display flex, all the boxes will arrange themselves in a row. Okay, so we have learned about the main axis and the cross axis. So if you let us align them along the main axis. So we need to write it as justify content, and then let me give it center. You can see that all the boxes have aligned themselves in the center. Let me just give a background color so you can understand better. Yeah, see, now all the boxes have aligned themselves horizontally in the center. So you can see the extra spaces. So there are more arrangements. Like if you want the spaces to be spread evenly, then what we can do? We can give space around. See, now all the boxes have arranged themselves with equal spaces around them. And they will always arrange them like that. Like whenever there is some extra space, it will be distributed equally around them, around the left side and the right side of the box. Is everyone able to understand?
Nishi, I guess your voice is not very clear. Can you just keep your mic just in?
Hello.
Hi. Yes, now it's fine.
Okay, thank you. Did you guys understand up till then?
Just repeat it once again because it was not clear, I guess.
And one more thing. Do you guys have the code? This code? Do you guys have this code of this flexbox?
No, they don't. I just wrote this one for explanation. Oh.
This is just for explanation.
Yeah,
just for explanation. So you just try to get the concept. You just try to get the whole concept. Continue.
Yeah.
Nishi, first try to explain that HTML document format. The flex container and the three items between them. I guess they are not understanding how you made these three containers.
Okay, sure. See, this is the HTML part. We have the flexbox container. And then inside the flexbox container, we have three flexbox items that are these. And I have named it as flexbox item 1, 2, and then 3. Okay. And then I'll just remove these. Yeah, so these was the initial setting. Okay. The flexbox item 1 was 100 pixel height. This one was 200 and this one was 300 pixel height. And all the box items had a width of 200 pixel each with a margin of 10 pixel, border, and a color. So now what happens when we give the display for the flexbox container, that is the container that contains all the boxes. If we give it a display flex, then all the flex boxes arrange themselves in a row. Okay, now let me give a background color to the flexbox container. So see, this is a container which contains all the boxes. And now since you've given it a display flex, then all the boxes will arrange themselves like this. That is in a row. And by default, all the boxes will stretch themselves till the end of the container because this is the default value of the flex. If you want to arrange them, like we don't want it to leave this space like this in the end, no, obviously. So what we can do is we can write it justify content and then space around. What this will help us see. All the extra space is now divided equally to the left side and the right side of the boxes. You can see in the center of the two boxes, we'll get twice the space which we get in the right side or the left side of one box. So this will be the content for space around. And if we give space between, in space between, see, the spaces are only in the between of the boxes. They are not there in the right side or the left side, that is the end of the boxes or the start of the container. And there is also one more, that is space evenly. Space evenly will distribute the extra space evenly at the start and in the middle part of the container. Anyone is having any doubt still here? Like, or someone wants to try something?
Guys, at least respond that you are with the code. Just respond once that you guys are getting what she's trying to say.
Okay, can anyone tell me that before writing the display flex line, the heights of the flex items were different? They were 100 pixels, 200 pixels, and 300 pixels. But as soon as we wrote the line display flex, the heights became even. They all, Nishi, your screen is not visible.
Okay.
Can you open the browser? The flex, yes. So as soon as we wrote the line display flex, the heights became same. Can anyone tell why that happened? If you guys don't understand anything, at least ask questions.
Yeah. like anyone is having any doubt or anyone wants to change anything, like justify content, try new things,
yeah, this is the last session that we are having for front end. For the next session, we are going to do back end. So just try to understand these things, because responsiveness is something that you need to do. Like this thing really takes time. This is basically responsiveness of a page. Please explain Flex again as a recap. Cool. Nishi,
yeah.
Give you a summary of Flex. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, okay. So for Flexbox, you just need to understand these two things. There are two accesses, okay. One is the main axis and the other is the cross axis. Main axis is always in the direction of the flex. See here, all the box items are arranged in a row. So the main axis will be along the row, that is in the horizontal direction. And cross axis will always be in perpendicular to the main axis. So cross axis will be vertical. Now main axis is used because, see, if you want to align the boxes along the like horizontal direction, then we have to write justify content. And if you want to arrange the boxes along the vertical direction, then we have to write align items. Like I've just showed justify content. Let me show align items also, it will be a bit clear. By default, align items is stretch. Okay, that is why all the boxes stretch themselves to the highest height they can get. Since, see, the first box had an height of 100, the other was 200 and 300, but now all the boxes are 300 pixels of height, because by default, align items, that is the horizontal axis arrangement, it is always stretch. But now we want to give it center, suppose. See, now they'll arrange themselves vertically, like along the vertical direction, they will arrange themselves and then come at the center of the like container. Then we can also give it like that. Yeah, so they'll always come at the top of the container like that. Now let us work with center only. And then there is one more interesting thing, see. Whenever we compress the the flex boxes will only compress themselves. No, and that is not always good, because we don't want it to compress that much. There is one more property, that is flex wrap. See, using this, all the boxes will arrange themselves accordingly. Like they'll not get compressed so much. Yeah, this was it. Like, just for the introduction for the Flexbox, anybody wants to ask something?
B, this one you told for the align items, right? And yeah. if you will do for the main axis, then?
Yeah, that is the justify content. Justify content will align them along the horizontal direction, and align items will align them in the vertical. Vertical direction, justify content is for horizontal direction.
Okay, you got.
Yeah, anything else? Otherwise you can just go to the blog page.
Did you guys understand the core concept of using Flexbox? We could have directly made this thing without using Flexbox also. Why did we decide to use Flexbox here? Did you guys understand that concept? That's the main reason we are that's the main reason for using Flexbox here. Otherwise we could have done it without Flexbox also. Anyone? What is the need of using Flexbox?
To make it more mobile responsive.
Okay. Yes. Mm-hmm. Basically, you can see how the element, the containers themselves align themselves based on their screen width. You see, when you make the width smaller, they all align themselves in a single vertical line. While you make the desktop view, it's aligned in the horizontal direction. So it is done by itself just by writing a single line of code. That's flex wrap equals to wrap. Okay. So you see how easy it becomes to make mobile the sites mobile responsive using Flexbox or even with grid. So that's the main idea of using Flexbox. Once the session is over, you can just make a simple, something of this sort, where you have some number of divs or containers, and then you can mess around with it with different sizes, with different options available with Flexbox and flex direction, flex size, whatever it is. You can just mess around with that.
Yeah, there is one more thing, like flex direction. I just missed that. If we write, see now, by default, the arrangement is raw. We can also change it. If I want flex direction to be column, I can give column also. Then they arrange themselves in a column. And then I can also give raw reverse. See now, first, the smallest box was at the first. Now the biggest box will be at the first. So that also will become very easy. If you want to change the direction, then just we need to write this line, nothing else.
So you see how easy it becomes. So anyone, do you have any doubts regarding this? Did you actually understand what's going on here?
Yes, yeah.
Yes, actually, you need to learn this thing, because think as if someone opens your portfolio or his mobile, then what is going to see? You just imagine what is going to see, because the homepage isn't responsive. So you need to make that homepage responsive, and using Flexbox, you can do that easily, right? You need to understand this thing. This is something which is really important for the front end of that.
Since you guys have understood this part, so we can move on to the next part. Okay. Is everyone fine with going to the coding part, like making the blog page? Yes, sir. Okay. Next we can start with the blog part.
Yeah, okay. See, first, let us understand what we need to write in the HTML part. So this is the blog page, right? So what do you think, like, what are the different sections which we need to add, or the different components? Can you see the black color border? Like, that should be the first thing, right? That wraps all the components. So I guess this should be the first thing that we need to add. Like, we can just name it as container or something. And then we need to add these three things, like the heading, the blocks, that is, we can just name it as raw because they're arranged in raw. Like, first can be the heading, raw, and then raw. And then under the heading, we can have the heading, like heading text. And then inside raw, we can have the blog image, the blog details, and the links. After that, since in the detail part also, we have three different sections, like we can divide it in three different sections, right? First can be the heading, and then the detail text. And the last one can be the read more button or the link. And for the links, we can also have two icons. That is, we can just give two divs with icon class, something like that. Is anyone having any problem? Like, this is the basic thing which we do. First, you need to divide it in different sections, and then we write it in the HTML. We write in the HTML part so that we can see what are the different sections, and then we style it in CSS. Like, it will be better if we do like this. Yeah. Is everyone having the navbar code?
So do you guys have the code for the first two sessions?
Yes, Bia.
Everyone?
Yes, Bia.
Because we'll be working with the same code.
Yeah. We need the navbar thing, right? See. Here we have the navbar thing. So we don't want it to write again. So a little better if you guys have that navbar code.
Blog will be entirely different page, so you will need to create a different page other than the index.html. Name it anything you want it to be. Okay.
Yeah.
Just create a new file with .html extension and just copy the code for the navbar in that file.
See, now I have the code, so I'll just copy it from the index.html part. Like, is everyone with me? Otherwise, if I go start now, it will be a problem. Everyone has copied the Laravel code. Please respond.
Nishu, you can do one thing. You can just post the same code in the chat section.
Yeah, sure.
I think we have the GitHub link, no? I think we have the GitHub link for that.
Yeah. You can get the codes for the navbar and the homepage also. Just copy the navbar part, that is still the header section in HTML. Like, just copy this part. And for the CSS thing, copy till line number 110 before the landing page. Before the dot landing page, just copy it till there. Please just respond whenever you are done with that.
I have also posted some important resources for today's session. We will be needing these images and font styles and the icons in today's session. So if when required, you can copy and paste these links in the in the text editor when that is told to you.
And then just create one more page for the, like, one more HTML file for this blog page. I've just named it blog page new. You can also create one more CSS file. Shall I continue now? Like, has everyone copied?
Yes, they did.
Okay. So now, after creating the CSS file, just link it with your HTML file. Do you guys know how to link it?
Yes, they did. We have told us.
Yeah, okay. Then just write link, press tab, and then write the path for the CSS file. That is, we have it in the CSS folder. And then the name which I'll be linking it is the blog page new. So you can just write the name which you have written with what you have named it. And then now let us start. So see, what is the first thing that you see? First we need to wrap it in the container. So let me create a class as container. And then inside the container, what we see, these are the three things, right? First is the heading, then two rows. Then let me write dot heading. And then one more will be row. Another row. Sorry. Yeah. So inside heading, now we have a text. See, we divided it into two sections, right? First was the heading. Like, inside the heading, we had the heading text. So we'll have heading text. And then inside drawers, inside draw we have three different sections, right? First we have the image, then we have the details part, and then we have the links. So we can write here dot blog image. And then we can have one more there. Let me name it blog, and then the links. Okay, now, yeah, I guess it is done. Now let me open it in the live server first. Yeah, since now we have not written anything, we don't have anything here. We just have the nav bar. So can anyone tell me what will be the heading text? Like from here. What should be the heading text? First section, first text. Is everyone writing the code?
If someone wrote in a chat section, should be blogs.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, Dash, it's correct.
Yeah. So see, we'll just write blogs. That should be the first heading. And then inside image, we have to add the image, right? We'll write image. And then, see, the link for the image you can get in the link that was provided earlier, right? See, you can get it from here. And in that one, the first link. Just copy the link and then add here. Add in the source section. And in the alternative text, you can just write project image.
Do you guys know what is the use of alt attribute in the image tags?
Yeah, does anyone know that?
If the image does not shows, then it shows.
Yeah, correct.
Okay. So see, we have added the image. Now in the blog section, what are the three different things? We have the heading, we have the details, and then we have the read more part. No. Then we'll just write the blog heading.
Can you explain the alt part again?
Yeah, okay. Alt is used whenever your image will not be able to load, no? Then that will be the text that will be visible in place of the image. Let's see. If I remove this too, image won't be visible, so we'll get this project image. Because I wrote project image in the alt tag.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, see, now the image is visible. We've added the actual heading. Heading is the lovely star. And then now let us add the blog details, okay. Okay, for the blog details, if you want dummy data, then you can just write Lauren and then press tab. We'll get a long line just for the dummy data. Then copy it once more. So now we'll get the dummy data till the blog detail it is done. Then we need to add the links. Let us check what is the scene. So see, we have the blog, that is the heading, the image, then the heading for the blog, the details. Now for the icons. See, we just need to go to the Bootstrap CDN font option. And go to the first link. So you'll get something like that. Just copy this link here. Everyone got this one? I think the link is also provided in the chat box. You can copy it from here also, font awesome CDN. This is used because we need this Facebook and Twitter icons, right? So for that we want to add these icons, but that won't be available like that. We need to link these files so that we can use this icon. Yeah, just write link and then paste the URL. If you did not get the URL, then you can just copy it from the chat box. Otherwise, you can write Bootstrap CDN font awesome. And then from the first link, you'll get there. After that, go to font awesome icons. And just go to the first site. See, this set is very nice. You can get all the icons here. We want Facebook, so I'll just make Facebook. And see, we got these three, right? Let me just copy this one. Yeah, you can copy it from here. Okay, copy this. And then inside link, let me just create one more class, that is icons. Yeah, inside the icon, see, these will be the anchor tags, right? Because we need to link it to Facebook and the Twitter profiles. So we can give it href, and then inside href we can give it hash. Hash will be useful because now we don't have any particular link. So hash is used if we want to reload the page whenever we click to the click in the particular image or the icon, then it will just reload the page. Now let us paste this one. Let's see what happens. See, we got this F, that is Facebook icon. And now let me just copy.
Nishi.
Yeah.
Turn on text trap in your VS code.
Okay, wait.
Shortcut is Alt Z. Shortcut, keyboard shortcut is Alt Z.
Okay.
Yes. Actually, the code was not visible.
Okay. Yeah, thank you. Now, let me copy it again. So, we want the same thing again, right? We just need to change the icon. So in Facebook, now we'll write, just go back and search Twitter. Let me copy this one. So see, this is the base of the website because this is the heading image, then this will be the heading of the blog, the details, and then the links. Now let us start with the CSS part. This is how the website will look if we had only HTML part. Now let us style it.
Excuse me, Didi.
Yeah.
From where did you get that write-up and all that? I have to copy that now.
Okay, just write, see, let me do it again. Just write lorem once, and when press tab, we'll get the dummy data.
Okay.
Yeah.
Actually, Lorem is a feature that is supported by VS Code and Sublime Text. It is used to add some dummy data to dummy text to your website, so that if we want, if we want to replace the text to the original text, then it can be done easily. So it is basically used for dummy data, dummy text, basically.
Yeah. Like, has everyone completed till this one? Like, we'll start the CSS part now. Is everyone with me?
I'm just checking up once.
Nishi, use square icon for Facebook.
Okay.
Just append hyphen square in the class name of the FA Facebook hyphen.
Okay. Square. Yeah, then we'll get the square part.
Yeah, we can proceed.
Okay, then let me start the signing part. You guys know the Google fonts, right? We have used the Gothic A1 last time. Everyone knows that.
Yes, Yidhi.
Okay, then I'll just copy the link. It is in index. Okay, it is not used. This link is also provided in a chat box. Just copy it from there. The Google Fonts link, that is the like font that we'll be using for this write-ups.
Actually, Nishi, it is not there. You can paste that chat in the chat box.
It is not there. You can just paste this one. Yeah, now let us start the CSS part. So see, you guys know about this pointer, right? This is used if you want to apply something to the whole content. And I want to the font family. Gothic A1. Since I've copied the link, it will work. So see, now what is the first thing that we need to add? You can see all the content is just like attached to the left hand side of the window. No, we don't want that. Then we can just apply a padding to the container. Why? Because container was the component, like it was a class that wraps everything up. See, container is the first part and that wraps everything up. And then we'll just give it a padding of like 0 pixel and 100 pixel. That is 0 pixel to the top and bottom, and 100 pixel to the right and left. So we can see this padding, right? That is provided to the right and left hand side. Then what do we need to adjust? The first part that comes is the heading. Okay, let me just write heading. The heading was the container that wraps the heading text. We want heading to be like a kind of height. Let me give it 200 pixels. So see, this is the this portion will be given to the heading part. Okay. And then we have heading text. Okay, no, we have the blog heading. Oh no, sorry. We have the heading text here. And just copy this. Yeah. Heading text. And then we can give it a position relative. And let me position it to top like 30%. Let's see what happens. And aligns, let me align it to center. I just saw heading text, heading text, position relative. Yeah. Yeah. See, it is done. And what is the next thing you see here? We need to change the size. Let me give font size to 60 pixel. Let's see what happens. Is it okay? 60 pixels. So, like, do you want me to change? We can adjust that. And it will change the color also. Hello, something like gray. Let me give it gray only. It is something like that. So we are done with the blocks. Like, that is the heading. Yeah. So what is the next thing you see? We had the raws part, right? We need to adjust this raw. For this raw. See, we'll have display flex for this raw because basically. See, these are the three items, right? First, second, and third. These will be arranged in a flex. So we'll give it a flex.
Guys, now you will see the magic of the flex box. We have arranged the everything in the HTML document. Now, as soon as you give the display flex property the row class, it will everything will turn into magic, and you will see that it will be looking very nice.
Yeah, see.
Apart from the padding and all, it is already looking like the one we have to make.
Yeah. See, you can see here, right? I guess I must read more part. Heading details, then the links. Let me add one more section, that is the read more. Read more. And then we'll have one anchor tag here. And hash again. The text we'll be using is read more. We have this read more also. Okay, let me open this blog page also here. See. We are almost there. We just need to apply some padding and all. Let us do that part now. Now I want to give a particular width to this blog part, okay? Okay, it is this much right now, and I'll give it a to the display flex. And then what are the things you see right now? Okay, I just showed you the display flex. In flex we can use justify contents if you want to align them horizontally. I don't want to add margin and all, so I can just write justify content, and then I can write space evenly. and let me give a margin bottom of 10 pixels. What is the next part we see here? Draw contains the blog image, the blog contains the blog heading details, and then the read more part. Okay. The next part that we have is the blog. Let me give it a width of 50%. So now it will only occupy the 50% of the total width, and we have, after that, what is the next thing you see that we need to change? See, the image is adjusted properly, the text is also adjusted, and the links are also there. So let us start with the blog heading. For that, let me write blog heading, and then now see what are the things that we can do here. First, we need to change the size, and let's see what happens. Font size can be like that was 60, so let me give it 40 pixels. Okay, it is looking good right now. Or now we can come to the blog details. Blog details. Let me just check it was details. Okay, blog details. Yeah. Now for the blog details, what are the things we can add? First, we need to add a margin because like it is just attached to it. Margin, then the size, and some like font. Font width and all. Let me give font. Okay, margin. In pixels. Yeah, I guess it is enough. After this, font size. 20 pixels. And if you want to make it a little bit bold, then you can just add font weight. Font weight, and you can give it. You can just try 400, how it looks like. So, I don't know. That is good now. See, it is almost looking like that. So now what is the next thing? We have the read more button, right? Read more tag, then for the read more tag. First, you need to give text decoration none. And you want to give it a text align of end. Yeah, so that it end, like it just comes to the end of the section, this section. Is everyone completed till here? Everyone has completed till here. It is only like only a little bit is left. Can anyone just say, are they following it?
Have everyone completed?
Okay.
Okay, now what is the next thing that you see it here? What is the next thing that you see? Yeah, this one should not be blue, right? This will be not in the read more, but it is in the read more anchor tag. It should be here. Text decoration, none. Yeah, I guess it is gone. And then let me increase its size. Yeah. See, now it is almost ready. Now we need to add the links part. What is the class? It was links. Okay, just copy that and you can paste. In link also we want a display flex. We can give it a display flex with direction column, because raw, like otherwise it will become raw. It will just show display flex. Okay. But we want it in column direction. So flex direction column. So now they are arranged like that, and we want to give some space between them. Then justify content. We can give it center. Or we can give it space evenly. Let's try. I guess it is looking okay. And then for the icons, let me increase the size of the icons. For that, we have to use font size. Font size, and let me give it 40 pixels. Okay, we can increase that. Dot icon. Oh, it was dot icons. S. I guess it is too big. Yeah, and then the color. No, I just was blue for that. Again, we need to add the same thing again, no raw. See, we added the same thing, then it will come again. But we can add some space here. So let me give a margin to raw. Okay, let's increase that. Yeah, I guess it is good now. Like, is everyone completed till here? Am I audible?
Yes, yes, Nishi. You are audible.
Yes, one minute, please.
Yeah, okay, you can write.